Hello, welcome back to FIFA. We had a good start with York City. In the top 10 of the table, I think. So, doing okay. Just thought I'd change a few of my players around, seeing as Berbatov just got injured. I think he's out for 4 weeks with a sprained ankle. So hopefully our other defenders will make do for the moment. I think the defender I've replaced him with is on loan from Blackburn. He's only 18, but he's decent. High 50s. Probably be low to mid 60s by the time this season's finished if I keep playing him. But for the moment I thought I'd look for a few more players. With low wage, obviously. Don't want to be spending too much. And high acceleration again. I like quick players. It's my thing, so this guy looks good. Decided I'd give signing him a go. Full season. Hopefully he can score me a few goals. His dribbling is decent as well. He's quicker than the rest of any of my players. Just save it a second. Now, against Birmingham. Hopefully, we can beat them. Get through to the next round of Capital One Cup. Get some more money. Just bring on Rodman, replace Gnabry on the right wing. So that their energy is higher. Can wear out Birmingham a bit. So, got off to a good start, got the ball off Birmingham. I had a shot with Gnabry, scores a beautiful goal. Hopefully he does that a few more times this season. It's looking like a good signing already. Got the ball back off them again. Just on the 10 minute mark. Played a nice pass into Rodman. Brings it forward, crosses it in, goes right across the face of goal. Get the ball again. Nice running by Walker. Gets blocked. They get the ball back straight from the keeper's kick. Play it through to Rodman. And the keeper saves it. Cross it from the corner. Head it forward. Miss again. Play the ball forward. Some nice passing again. Get the ball to Gnabry to cross it in. Overhead it a bit, and then somehow managed to head it across goal twice. Get the ball again. Dribble it fast, almost get tackled. Rodman takes it on. Fanny's around with it for a bit. Farronen, ah. I was absolutely all over them this game. I think they had one shot on target. Absolutely dominating them. Can't believe it's still only 1-0 at the moment. Just random shot from a distance there. Get the ball back again. Start the second half. Pass it through their team. Some nice running by McLaughlin. And a good pass to Mazaros. Made a nice run up the side. Rodman knocks it in from Walker's header. On 51 minutes. Sorry about the mouse there. I didn't realise it could see it. Good keeping by my goalie. Punches it straight out to my player. Take the ball forward, all the way from the back. Work my way forward. Some nice passing. It's easy to keep the ball in this game, so I don't concede often, but I don't score enough. Kind of a pointless shot from a distance there. Once again, the keeper works out. I get it straight back. Nabry plays a nice pass to Rodman, and Rodman hits it just wide. Rodman's a very good player as well. Very good winger. McCready manages to not knock it in there somehow, but Nabry gets it back, dribbles it past, and it gets blocked. But then, for some reason, I get a penalty, so Walker steps up to take it and hits it around the top corner. Pretty good at penalties. I don't miss often. There's pain sometimes when I miss it and hit it in a direction, the keeper won't save it. And other times I absolutely blast it in the corner and the keeper will save it. I don't quite understand how that works. So got the ball back again, straight through, and Robin sets up Walker. So Walker's got two this game, Robin's got one, and Nabry's got one. Give the ball to Nabry again, cuts inside, shoots, just over. I got an offer for Daniel Parslow just after the game, so decided I'd accept that, get myself some more money. It's only 55 overall after all. So then sell him, goes through to transfer deadline day. Thought I'd have a look at a few more players eventually. If I look at a few more loan players of high acceleration again, see if I can get a midfielder maybe. But I forgot to set the wage cap. Then decided I'd look at a few free agents instead. See if there are any bargains. But I kept messing up the search. Okay then, third time lucky. There's a few good ones here. I'm looking for young players. Then I noticed there's a 17-year-old with an overall of 64 who will in all likelihood become amazing. So I try and sign him. Probably signing the season if I manage to get him. So now I adjust my budget, give myself more wages for the transfer market, because I'm not going to be signing any players for money, as I've said before. There's no point really in the lower leagues. Even in the higher leagues, really, once you get higher, there's a lot of good free agents available as you go through the leagues. So then Azogue accepted my offer, so I signed him. As you can see, I forgot to accept the Vitinha offer there. He accepted my offer the day before the transfer season, but I accidentally wasn't recording then, so I'll go back to accept it. Got him now, got another decent striker, so now I've got Walker and Vitinha. But the formation I play, 4-3-3, means I only need two strikers really. So I sold Scott Kerr to Exeter. Because I've just signed Azogue, so I don't need that many midfielders now. But I think I have a surplus of strikers, not very good strikers at the moment. But despite that, I look for more free agents, and then I find Tim Payne, who's only 18 and is overall 60. I'm a bit unsure whether I should sign him or not, so I've got a few other players. Then I decide I'll see if there are any young players of a lower overall that I could sign, but Tim Payne's the only one. So I give signing Tim Payne a go, see if he'll join me. Hopefully he'll accept. Then I add Antwoord. I've only got a few hours left to the end of the transfer deadline day. So hopefully he decides to join me. Although, it doesn't look like he's going to be. Nope, he didn't want to sign, so I'll probably try and sign him in January, I guess. I've forgotten his name now, but I'll have to look back and check. As a third young striker would be good. And when I get to January, I'll be able to sell the players that it wouldn't let me sell this transfer period, because apparently I'd only just signed them. Because they'd only just signed in real life. So now we're against Fleetwood Town. I think in the league, in real life, I'm recording this audio on the 16th of February, and Fleetwood are currently 5th, with a game in hand over the two teams above them. They have 50 points, and if they win today, which is Saturday, then they'll go 3rd above my home team, Exeter City. So, I'm hoping they don't. So you can see Bordeaux's still injured, but he's on the way back, so he'll probably be able to play again in a couple of games. Look around my team. I decide I won't start Azog, and I'll play Potts instead. Potts, McLaughlin and Varanen, with Navri Walker, Robman up front, Meseros, O'Connell, Smith, Obeng and Leandro in defence. I'll get the ball straight from kickoff, run forward with Potts for a bit, pass it to Navri. Navri gives it back. Potts plays a nice ball into Rodman. Rodman passes it to Walker. Manages to dribble pass with Walker. He shoots and it goes just over. The number of shots I have compared to the other team in every single game is ridiculous. I'm playing on world class, but the computer just doesn't seem to shoot. They don't get the ball forward enough. So you get another shot there. The problem is, they always score on the counter-attacks. Because I'm attacking so much, so they always end up scoring on a counter-attack, as you just saw. It's a pain in the arse. And because I'm attacking so much, it's impossible for me to score on a counter-attack, because I constantly have the ball, and their defenders are constantly back, so there's not as much space behind the defenders as there would be if I was attacking on the counter-attack. So they came close again there, just after I said they hadn't had many shots. Typical. So I get the ball in Nabry, tap it round him, cross the ball in, straight to the keeper. Then at half time side, I will make a few subs, bring on Azog and Vitinho. See if that changes anything. Vogue plays a simple pass to Vitinho. Vitinho dribble past two players. Shot saved, but Varanen scores the rebound. Get the ball with Azog again, passes it to Vitinho. Vitinho shoots just wide. Meseros, oh, he's such a good defender. He's played amazing. I think he's probably the best left back you can sign for lower leagues. Hit it just wide there. I've seen some of my players a bit tired, so I decide I'll make another substitution. So I bring on Blair for Nabry, because he's getting a bit knackered. Kapu gets another shot there, keeper saves it. And another, but it goes wide. Then Azog plays a nice pass to Vitinho. Vitinho shoots, almost scores. Defence clears it. Azog heads it straight back. And then Varanen plays a nice ball to Rodman, and Rodman hits it just wide. Now Azog sprinting with it. His dribbling's really good. He's quick as well. Some lovely running by Azog, but hits it straight at the goalie. Yeah, that game ended 1-1. Now against Torquay, who are 18th in the league at the moment, with 30 games played, so they've actually got two games in hand over some teams. They're Exeter's rivals, so hopefully we can beat them and put a dent in their hopes in this game, if they're challenging for the top or not. I'm not sure they are. pass it away to Walker. Walker passes it back into Messeros. Messeros to Vitinho. Vitinho loses the ball, goes to Messeros and hits it just wide. Creedy passes it forward to McLaughlin. McLaughlin plays a nice pass to Vitinho. Vitinho dribbles it past, cuts inside, and hits it just over. Nice pass to Blair. Blair hits out wide to Obeng. Good running from Obeng. Crosses it in, and Walker hits it just wide again. Can't keep missing. Forward to 66 minutes now. Vitinho dribbles it past. Scores a lovely goal into the bottom left corner. Vitinho's good. Very good. Dribbling and paces. Very handy. Bit more mobile than Walker. Just going to make a few subs again. My players are getting tired. Bring on Rotman. McLaughlin plays it to Creedy, who somehow manages to not score. Then they get a throw. Throw it to Blair. Pass it into Walker. Walker knocks it with one touch. Hits it into the left side of the goal. With a beautiful finish. Get the ball to Walker again. Brandon plays a nice pass forward to Walker. Walker's one on one. And I managed to cock it up and run into the goalie. I could have sworn I pushed the A button, but apparently not. So the keeper whacks out. And that's the end of the game. And I won 2-0. So, season's going off well. Gone to a very good start. Hopefully we can continue that. That's the end of part 3. See you next time.